close to you.
Oh, really? You ate it before I did.
What? What's going on?
You ate it before I did.
You know, hanging out with Nick that allowed me to breathe again and to have fun and just smile. I just had a great time.
Did you hear that?
No? Yep.
Where did you go last night? What happened? You just like disappeared.
I went to the strip club.
What?
I met a cool chick. She's a stripper.
But she was a stripper.
Don't go there. Don't do strippers. Don't do that.
But what time did you get home?
Like 5.
5?
Yeah.
Wow.
Oh, you weren't even here.
I stayed in Joey's room.
Yeah. We had a slumber party in my room.
We were having girl talk because last night, Corey
was tripping again.
Corey was really jealous because he saw those photos of me on a horse with Nick playing polo and laughing and having fun. And that, of course, made things a million times worse.
Who did you go out with? Who was there? Where'd you go?
Oh, yeah.
He was totally harassing you.
And he called my mom and my dad. Corey called me 86 times that day. It can't, like, be like this forever, you know? Like, I forgave him for all those photos and everything, him flirting with other girls.
But did you really? Because you don't forget it. You remember it, and it stays inside of you and lives inside of your heart.
Finding naked pictures on Corey's phone happened twice, and the first time he cried and said it would never happen again. He was asking for these photos, telling them, like, oh, yeah, babe, send another one. That's hot.
Seriously, are you listening to what you're saying? It's always him doing terrible, unforgivable things.
My advice for Adrina with the whole Corey thing is let him loose. Get rid of him. He is obsessive, and I just feel like that's dangerous for Adrina. Tell her, Team Nick.
Old Nick sounds like some brother-in-law material.
What? Yeah! See? Team Nick t-shirts.
Are you serious?
Jeez.
Last night, it was a breath of fresh air. Like, being around someone who's, like, secure and happy and no drama, it's refreshing.
Yeah.
You know?
He's got to figure it out.
I'm not doing this because of Nick. Like, this has been a long time coming.
Exactly. Exactly.
Check my phone. And it just so happens, oh, it's Corey.
Of course it is.
Now he's calling me.
Answer it.
Look, your hand is shaking. You're nervous.
I know. Corey.
You want to do it like this?
He's literally like a professional manipulator.
I'm just sick of fighting.
It's so obvious what you need to do.
Corey, are you there?
Yeah. When we go to bed, we call each other, right?
Do you think I did something wrong?
You ignored my calls and messages.
I'm sorry, but I don't stare at my phone waiting for you to text me. I told you that I would call you when I was done, and I'm sorry I didn't call you before I went to bed.
Well, then explain last night. Let's go through it right now, then.
Corey always asks me to explain your night. He wants to know detail for detail. And if you want to sit here and talk about it right now...
I do, because I've been up all night.
Really, Corey? You're going to play the whole, oh, boo-hoo, you hurt me card?
You have no compassion, no nothing right now in your voice. You're just angry.
Corey has this way of turning things around to make you feel like it's your fault. He gets really sad and cries and, like, plays victim.
I don't even care. You must have, Trina.
You act like, what do you think I did?
You called me at 3 o'clock. Were you done filming at 3 a.m.? Yeah, you stick to your word, Trina. When I go away, I'm going to stick to my word too, right? That's how we do this.
Stop.
He's manipulating you.
Corey, we're together every single day, all the time, and you can't even let me be and have fun for 2 days?
Is that what you want me to do, not call you at the end of the night?
No, we can talk, but I don't need to talk to you every minute, every hour of the day.
Well,
The entire time I can't even have fun with Joey and my brother because I'm constantly worried about you being angry at me for not calling you back right away, for not texting you back right away, and that's not right.
Why are you getting so aggressive right now?
Because it's the same thing over and over and over again.
Alright, well, I'm sorry for taking up your time, Junior, okay? I'm sorry for Karen, alright?
See, well, this is such a mind f- and I'm over it. I gotta go. I'll talk to you later.
He's literally like a professional manipulator.
Okay, I'm not gonna answer it.
He's like a child. And you're not a babysitter. That was really good. Really impressed. Now stick to it.
I just feel confused and hurt, and I don't know what to do. I'm sick of fighting over nothing. I just feel like Corey and I, we can't keep fighting like this. It's unhealthy. And if he's never gonna trust me, I mean, I don't know what to do. And I'm sick of him turning it on me, acting like he's so innocent and he didn't do anything wrong, yet he's the one who started this entire fight. I don't know what to do. Like, I love Corey and I want to make things work, but I can't, it is unhealthy, and we just keep fighting all the time. And I hate seeing guys cry, like Corey crying.
And you don't think he knows that, by the way? Why do you feel guilty about somebody who totally disrespects you and manipulates you all the time? It's so obvious what you need to do. And you need to just be like, you're done, and be strong, because you are strong. I feel like you know what you need to do.
I've always told myself I'm never gonna be that girl to let a guy control me. And that's what I'm turning into, and I don't like how I feel.
So what are you gonna do?
No, I'm torn right now. It really just brought everything into perspective. Look at how nice you look. And I was really excited to go to the polo match and just have a good time. I happened to run into Nick right away.
You look really pretty.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It was nice to see him again. So how was your match?
Good, it was good. We won, which is really good.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so.
I feel like there was chemistry between Nick and I from the moment we met. There was something there. So now you gotta celebrate. Yeah. And it's something that I hadn't felt with anyone in a really long time.
Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers. Congratulations.
Congrats on winning, man.
Yeah, buddy.
So are they just practicing out here right now?
Yeah, they're just warming up.
My arm is so sore.
How are your legs? The inside of your legs.
Okay.
In light of Corey's recent behavior, Nick came at the perfect time, like a knight in shining armor.
What time do you guys fly out tomorrow?
9 a.m.
9 a.m.? That's it? We're done? Never see you guys again?
That's a wrap.
Being in Palm Beach with Nick, you know, God had that weekend planned out for a reason, and I met him for a reason. So you never know. Everything works. Everything falls into place as it should.
But Nick here mentioned that he wanted to come to LA now, right?
Okay.
Nursing your sick dog.
Okay, so you're coming out. Being in Palm Beach, I think it really opened my eyes. It allowed me to breathe again and to have fun and just smile and be myself.
It's halftime. Let's go. Stop some divots. Besides, stop issues you got.
And now it's kind of like I have to go back to LA and I have to deal with drama.
See something like that? I mean, that's not really a divot. You just stomp on it. There you go.
Hopefully I'll see Nick again, you know, when the timing's right.
It's an honor to meet you.
I'll stay in contact with him. We'll see what happens.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'm getting all like flushed. Oh my god.
Now we know what polo is.
Now you know what polo is.
Now I'm the
Stomp
polo.
The hell out of the ground without stepping on poop.
Watch the poo.
Watch the poo.
That's my one little word of advice.
Next time on Audrina. I met up with Casey and she had no idea my dad was coming.
Hey girls. How's it going?
Are you serious? This is a trap. I'm walking into a trap right now. That night, my mom freaked out like you didn't say anything.
It's time to end things with Corey. And I'm just afraid because he has a really bad temper.